Okay guys, so I'm here to talk about Major League Baseball and more specifically, this is part two of a video I did a long time ago, how to increase the popularity of Major League Baseball. Now, we all know that the popularity over the past 5 to 10 years of Major League Baseball has gone way down. And we have noticed it even more over this past year. I'm just going to use the Texas Rangers as an example. The Texas Rangers on July 16th, 2012, a year ago today, had a record of 54-35. They had a 5.5 game lead on Anaheim. And their attendance was 43,619. Fast forward to today. The Texas Rangers have a 54-41 record and are 2 games behind the Oakland A's. Their attendance is down from what it was last year to 39,138. So that's about 4,000 less people attending a Texas Rangers game every night. So, in order to bring this trend back up, I'm gonna review what I said in part one very quickly. Then I'm gonna get into some new stuff that I got of. What I said in part one, the first idea I came up with was have built-in doubleheaders into the schedule. And the reason why I say this is because we all know the playoffs start in early October. I personally don't like it because I think baseball is not meant to be playing the cold. So, if you have like 6 or 7 doubleheader games, that'll end the season in early to mid-September. That way you can start the playoff earlier where there's still some hot weather and you can get better baseball. It'll be beneficial for the fans because I know since I'm a New York Yankee and have gone to playoff games. We freeze to death out there. It's very, very cold. So if you start the playoffs in early September, you get hot weather for the fans, and that might increase attendance in some parks. The second thing that I said in part one was basically create a TV deal for the minor leagues. That way, you could expose minor league players and fans know who they are, so when they come up, they're familiar with their swing, what pitches they like, Cause we at what picture they don't like, cause we at when they go through slumps, how do they get out of it? Right now, all we can see from minor league baseball are the Sox and maybe some All-Star games. That's about it. If Major League Baseball signs a deal with MLB Network for example, or ESPNU, they could expose minor league players to the fans. That way, when they come up, the fans are more invested in them. Now, getting on to the new stuff that I thought of. The first thing I will do if I Major League Baseball is mandate that college players stay in college for 2 or 3 years. And the reason why I say this is because, first of all, once they get out of college, that makes them more prepared to come up to the majors as fast as possible. As opposed to a high school player who, while he's younger, you're gonna have to wait 4 to 7 years to see him in the majors. So it would be beneficial for Major League Baseball to mandate that they stay in college for 2 or 3 years. Because that way, like I said, fans can watch college baseball on ESPNU and they also could get exposed to them, invest in them, and they know that they'll come up much quicker as opposed to a high school player. The third and final thing that I would do if I'm Major League Baseball, I said this a couple of videos back, is move the All-Star game towards the end of the season. And here's why. That way you won't have a controversy of whether Yasiel Puig is an All-Star or not. You get more chances to see if he's a real deal, and then you could vote him in. That way, Major League Baseball purists don't have an excuse to not put him in the All-Star game. I'll leave that video along with the part one of this video down below in the description. That's it for right now, guys. Peace.